Hey, welcome back. So, super important that we have a conversation as we're living in this new digital world, working from home. It's changed our working environments, our workplace relationships, and certainly we have a whole new reality of how we function. A challenge is sexual harassment, unfortunately, has also adapted. An expert on the topic of employment law, and certainly an expert on this topic of digital sexual harassment in the remote workplace, Christina Hynes Mesco from Chicago's Prince Law Firm is joining us here on Get Down to Business. Christina, welcome to the program.
Thank you so much for having me, Shalom.
It's such a pleasure, and I appreciate your important work on this topic. And we'll talk a lot more about digital sexual harassment. We'll talk about that checklist that you've helped build for companies to ensure that employees are feeling safe, welcomed, and included in work. But let's talk about your background. Christina, you are, again, employment law expert. Tell us a little bit of how you got into employment law and some of your interesting work.
Yes, thank you. I more or less fell into employment law through a clerkship program and really then fell in love with it thereafter. I think my passion really centers on promoting the dignity of workers. I think, you know, for business owners, employees are the most valuable asset you have. You treat them right and they will be loyal to you and go above and beyond for you. As employees, you know, I've worked with so many employees who have been discriminated against or been harassed and held their hand through that process. And really it's kind of what keeps me up at night and gets me up in the morning is a passion for making sure that employees are respected in the workplace.
Super, super important. So your firm, let's talk about this for a moment. I've known several of your colleagues and you guys are doing fantastic work. So it didn't surprise me when I heard that you are on the cutting edge of research into this important topic. So the Prinz Law Firm, tell us a little bit about your team.
So yes, the Prinz Law Firm was founded in 2009 by Kristen Prinz. She's a fantastic attorney and an equally brilliant business person as well. And so we clerked together before we graduated from law school and kind of were baby attorneys together. And she went out and started her own firm, really with, a passion for helping clients that were business owners realize their goals and comply with employment law at the same time. And then also help those individuals who've been harmed by their employers seek redress for the issues that they have, both through negotiation, through litigation. So our firm does a lot of work on behalf of employers, but we do represent employees as well. And that runs the gamut from drafting policies and writing contracts, and then of course litigation when those issues and disputes cannot be resolved.
Absolutely, and I appreciate that background and appreciate again you and your colleagues and all that you are doing. So let's talk about your current workplace. You are likely throughout COVID, you have certainly been, right now we're having this conversation actually recording through Zoom. Many offices have been using Teams, all sorts of different platforms. How did that influence your research and again that development of the checklist, which I think is so important?
I think that obviously our own office, which is downtown in the Loop in Chicago, needed to pivot and go remote, and which we were thankfully able to do in this digital age. Many others experience the same things. But what we've seen as this has unfolded is that the harassers that exist in workplaces everywhere have just found more methods and means in which to harass their victims. And so we had to sort of take a different look at what sexual harassment looks like in the remote workplace versus, the traditional idea that people have. The boss comes up and puts his arm around the subordinate junior employee and then she feels uncomfortable. We're kind of away from that, what, like 1985 HR video type sexual harassment at this point. Now we're seeing sexual harassment occur in the context of conference calls and video meetings, all of those channels through which employees can communicate, text messages, a lot of employees use chat platforms like Slack or Google Chat. We're seeing things start to pop up there that are rising to the level of creating a sexual harassment, hostile work environment for employees?
Okay. Well, so important, and definitely you're seeing those trends. And as you learn what is happening, and you're certainly on the front lines of seeing what is taking place in the world of employment law, you have taken a proactive approach to this. So we're going to get into that checklist. We're going to talk a little bit about some of the workarounds and efforts that employers should be putting in place to make sure, again, that employees are feeling welcomed and included at work, regardless of what workplace they're in person or digital. Again, Christina Hynes Mesco from Chicago is the Prinz law firm. I want to make sure that our listeners know where they can get a hold of you and your team so they can have a consultation and a discussion.
Yes, definitely. So our website is probably the best avenue. We're also on social media, but www.prinz-lawfirm.com. And there you'll find a plethora of information on all the topics that touch employment law, particularly sexual harassment and especially sexual harassment in the digital age. We're also linked on social, Facebook, Twitter, LinkedIn, as well. And you can always pick up the phone and call us the old-fashioned way, too.
Okay, fantastic. Well, Christina, I've got to squeeze in a very quick break. Encourage all of our listeners to get on my website, where I'll link to your firm as well, shalomklein.com. That's where you can download podcasts. But again, Christina Hynes-Mesco, stick with me. We're going to squeeze in a quick break. More about that checklist, more about digital sexual harassment in the remote workplace when we return. Welcome back. I've been chatting with employment law expert Christina Hynes-Mesco from Chicago's Prinz Law Firm. And Christina, you've been sharing that you've been hearing about inappropriate comments, explicit photos, other misconduct that's being used on all sorts of platforms used by employees. There's Microsoft Teams, Slack, Zoom, private media, text messages, all of those things. It's certainly been an adaptation in a good way of how we can be productive. But as we said when we started the conversation, sexual harassment has adapted as well. So, Christina, you and your team have adapted as well and coming up with some ideas and some solutions that that our listeners hopefully can put in place immediately. Tell us some of your advice.
Absolutely. Yeah. So first, I mean, some simple non-monetary changes you can make and ensure that you have going on already. Set your workforce up for success in corresponding and engaging remotely. Remind employees to bring their best professional selves to work and to virtual meetings. You know, in some situations, it may be appropriate to suggest a dress code for remote meetings so that no one feels uncomfortable. Using like standard virtual backgrounds for Zoom meetings, perhaps someone with your business is low, might be helpful. That helps protect employee privacy, because we have seen some instances where harassers have used background or information contained in the background of the alleged victim to harass them. So simple things like just getting your workforce imagining that they're back in the office, even if they're not. Having policies that prohibit sexual harassment in the workplace. Of course, most employers have those already, but make sure that your business's expectations around electronic communications are clear. Prohibit sharing of sexually suggestive or explicit content in workplace settings and on company devices and through communication channels. You know, jokes, just like in the office, they leave them for later with your non-work friends. If you must engage in those, because those can create a hostile work environment. And I think the next two very important pieces of this are train employees and managers to understand and identify sexual harassment. So really look for anything that is sexually tinged, any conduct, you know, words, images, behaviors that are sexually tinged or could, you know, have that opportunity to turn, you know, comments on appearance, for example, would be something that might turn into something that could be harassing. But so look for anything that might be sexually tinged that alters the employment environment for workers. Sometimes it's obvious if someone's the the subject of harassment, that they're nervous and they can't, you know, they're not focusing, or they're having difficulty in the workplace, speak out on behalf of them and make sure that all employees know how to report sexual harassment. And then really, Shalom, one of the biggest things that we see is that employers need to investigate complaints and take action. Don't sweep it under the rug. If you get a complaint or you see behavior that should be, you know, maybe investigated, even if it's seemingly innocuous, talk about it, figure out how to approach it, ensure that your workers are okay, ask questions and have conversations around this so you can understand where, you know, opportunities exist to better your environment in this regard.
Mm-hmm. And as I always say on the program, it's important that this is not just for large organizations. This is something that small businesses can and should put in place as well, because it's everybody's responsibility to ensure a safe workplace, whether it's in person or remote. So again, employment law expert Christina Hynes Mesco from Chicago's The Prinz Law Firm. Really appreciate that advice, that information. You've already shared some of your contact information, but one more time, can you share your website?
Sure. It's www.prinz-lawfirm.com.
Fantastic. Well, Christina, thank you so much for sharing your expertise on this such an important issue. That will be a wrap for us here on Get Down to Business. We're going to be back next Sunday at 6 p.m. right here on AM 560. The Answer. Go to my website, shalomklein.com. Success. Let's get down to business. Looking forward to continuing our conversation on business, jobs, and entrepreneurship next week.